I was just bringing John Ross up to speed.
We're never gonna find the petty mugger that shot my father, but we are no closer to executing JR's master plan than we were a month ago.
I spoke with Ellis at the U.S. Attorney's office, son. His friends in the State Department are busy trying to track your mother in Abu Dhabi, but they need more time. Harris Ryland.
He was the biggest contributor to the governor's campaign. That could mean...
The governor is in his pocket.
Which is why Ryland needed me to lose the election. So Harris Ryland and the governor are putting pressure on Tesha to cover up the sabotage and put the blame on us. But why? Why would Ryland be involved in this? Bobby, we're in a stickier web than we realized. But I think you, Christopher, and John Ross know more than you're letting on. Tell me what's going on.
JR knew that Cliff and Harris would join forces and come after us. That's why he wanted us to have this. All pieces to the puzzle of his master plan. To take them down once and for all. Barnes' global financial history, Ryland's trucking in Mexico, Christopher's mother's whereabouts. Somehow it's all connected. John Ross, Christopher, and I are trying to figure it all out, connect the dots, finish what JR started. We need to find a way to ruin them before they ruin us. John Ross copied this from Pamela's computer. It's Rebecca Wentworth's will, who, as you know, is Cliff's mother. Rebecca left her entire estate to her three children, Catherine, Cliff, and Pam. That includes her shares of Barnes Global. If I read this right, her estate is a living trust. Which means if we can't find Pam, or if she's dead...
Her shares go to me.
One-third of Barnes Global.
It's looking more and more like Cliff and Ryland are coming for us together, just like JR predicted.
If we can get Pam's shares, we can kick the legs out from under Cliff. Maybe his entire plan. That's why JR wanted us to find Pam. That's our move.
There's no way my mother just vanished into thin air. Surely your contacts in Washington have turned up something by now. I mean, doesn't the State Department track the movements of American citizens overseas?
Yes, but as you can see, your mother's passport expired in 1998, and it hasn't been renewed since.
What about the IRS? Has she filed a tax return?
Not since 1989. According to my friend at Treasury, all the dividends paid to her as one-third owner of Barnes Global have been sitting in a trust account untouched since then.
I'm sorry I don't have more information. The truth is, your mother could just as easily be dead as she could be off the grid.
Good. Then give me a death certificate. I want you to have my mother declared legally dead.
I can't just snap my fingers and produce a death certificate. This is the government.
You know, not so long ago, you assured us that Vicente Cano would face justice here in the U.S. and never be extradited. And 3 days later, he was in my living room with a gun to my fiancé's head. So I'm thinking you owe us, Ellis.
When do you need it?
Yesterday.
Hey. Hey. Oh.
Son, how'd it go with Ellis?
Good.
So he has news about your mother?
No, nothing. Maybe it's for the best.
What do you mean?
I asked Ellis to use his contacts to have my mother declared legally dead.
So you can inherit her shares?
Yeah.
Searching for your mother?
Why would you keep something like that from me?
Because I knew you wouldn't approve. I mean, you got angry with me when I told you about the blackmail. You said my family was a pit of snakes. I didn't tell you because it's part of a bigger play against Cliff Barnes. I'm trying to get my mother declared legally dead.
Dead? Christopher, what is going on?
Cliff is coming for us, all right? And not just with the rig. He bought our loan. He's trying to take over Ewing Energies. You know, if I can get my mother declared dead, I'll inherit her shares of Barnes Global.
Do you hear yourself? You're talking about declaring your mother dead like it's a business transaction.
It is. Look, we need to start taking from Cliff what he's trying to take from us. This is a means to an end.
Coming to terms with the idea of your mother's death can't be this easy. You need time to process.
My mother left when I was 7, without so much as a goodbye. The truth is, she was dead to me years ago. Maybe now something good can finally come of it.